Now, before the show, we met some of you, and we asked some of you to stare into a drinking glass and then to visualise an object inside of it. And once you've done that, we asked you to write it down on a single piece of confetti. I can see all sorts of things in here. Someone's written a glass of water, 50-pound notes, that sort of thing. One of these objects will select itself.
I love stuff like this.
Simon, would you read out what's written on that piece of confetti? What object is that?
It's something I don't like.
Okay.
An egg.
An egg? An egg, it is a reminder that everything in our life starts as something smaller. It is fragile, it's perfect. And so all I have to do is visualize that piece of confetti getting heavier. And if you listen, you may be able to hear it. And I have to visualize it changing form. Growing.
What?
Wow.
That's mental.
That's so cool.
That was amazing.
Thank you all so much. Now, for this next piece, I will need somebody from the audience. I will take this paper aeroplane, I will throw it out into the audience, one of you will catch it. Coming out over there. See, it soars gracefully. I'm gonna get you to unfold that piece of paper for me, where you'll find it's not any old piece of paper. What it is it's a seating plan of this very theatre. Take that piece of paper for me, hold it behind your back. Then I'm gonna give you this pen. I'm gonna make you take this pen and make a dot or a mark somewhere on the page behind your back so that you don't know where you're going. Do that for me now, just a little dot. Have you done that? Okay, great. Will you have a look? Where did you put your little mark on the paper?
The seat number is L34.
Okay, L34. L34? Is this 34? Hello! What's your name?
My name's Annika.
Annika. Annika, I think you'll be absolutely perfect with this. Are you okay to help me? Okay. Would everybody here give Annika a huge round of applause as she comes on stage? Quick as you can, Annika, follow me. Watch your step on the way up. These are two autoconductive cages. You can see underneath them, you can see through them, you can see above them. This one's exactly the same. And they're connected in circuit to this Tesla coil. I need you to step up into this cage. Nicely done. Now, Annika, I need you to keep your hands behind your back. Are you ready? Don't worry. And so, all I have to do is to complete the circuit. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Last time I performed for you, I tried to fill the stage with as much equipment as I could fit in. But it turns out what captured your imagination was something very small and simple. It was a tiny little egg. And it reminded me that sometimes the most magical moments in our lives are the smallest moments. And so tonight I thought I'd arrive with almost nothing, just an empty glass and a saucer. I'll leave the glass here, covered by the saucer. That will create a sort of impenetrable chamber. Amanda, will you keep your eyes on that for
yes.
me? And I thought, what's the smallest miracle I could perform? Well, the smallest thing I can perform magic with is a single match from a book of matches. This one, in fact. Now, I need you to remember me tearing this match out of the book, And in a moment, Alicia, I'm going to get you to hold on to the matches, keep them very safe. But first, I will cast a spell of fire. You don't seem very impressed. Alicia, hold on to those for me. I will attempt to make this match disappear. It's very hot, I've got to be very careful. Gone.
Don't try this at home.
But wait. Did you feel anything?
No.
I hope you felt something, I just blew at your hand. But something else happened. That match managed to travel through the air and reappear somewhere I could never have gotten to. In your hand. Have a look. Because inside the matchbook where it originally began is that match. Show them.
Wow.
Now, you will have noticed that even though the match vanished, there was almost no smoke. That's because the smoke travelled somewhere I also couldn't have gotten to. Inside the glass. Alicia, keep hold of those matches for me. Keep them tightly held in your fist. Simon, I need you to choose a card for me. These are all totally different, of course, and would you touch the back of absolutely anyone you like, and it doesn't matter if I see what it is. So just touch one, take it out. That one there?
Mm-hmm.
Have a look at it. What is it?
9 of clubs.
The 9 of clubs. The 9 of puppy feet. Will you hold your hand out flat for me like a table? I will attempt... Oh, actually, you know, Simon, all these years, you've seen so many magicians on Got Talent. Have you ever performed the magic yourself?
No.
Tonight, you will make the card disappear for us. Just tell me the moment that you've done it.
Now.
Oh, yeah, I felt it too.
Oh, wow.
Oh. Alicia, did you feel anything?
I did that time.
You did?
Good.
That card managed to travel through the air and reappear somewhere totally impossible. So, Alicia, the end of my routine is entirely in your hands.
Are you serious?
Oh, just the matches. Open them up. The card isn't in the book. It is the matchbook. The best pieces of magic, just like the best stories, have a beginning, a middle, and an end. And seeing as we're at the end of my Britain's Got Talent journey, I thought I would tell you about my beginnings in magic. And it all began with a story that my grandfather told me about his childhood growing up as he did in India. Now the story begins like any good story a grandfather might tell a grandson. He said, "Ben, first I will require your imagination." So I gave him my imagination. He said, "Ben, when I was about your age, we witnessed the heaviest monsoon season in 1,000 years, where the raindrops were so big they were the size of mangoes, and the streets had all turned to rivers. One day, when I was sheltering beneath a canopy, I met a traveling magician, and he did something truly impossible. Something so impossible, you will hardly believe me when I tell you, because I can hardly believe it myself. He had a fan of playing cards, and he waved his hand in front of the cards, and the cards appeared to shrink. Now, I can't tell you now exactly whether the cards shrank or whether maybe his hands just grew, but they did appear to be smaller. And he waves his hands again, and now they're just the size of rose petals. And he waves his hands again, and now they're just the size of blossom. And one at a time, the hair stands up on the back of my neck. He waves his hands again, and now they're just the size of grains of rice, and then sand, and then just dust, and then atoms that he sprinkles into the rising floodwater. And before I get a chance to look back, he has disappeared off into the rain. Now, this story had such a huge impact on a young me getting into magic. I was so taken by it because it was so vivid in my imagination. Now, in order for me to share that with you, you'd have thought I'd need big Hollywood special effects. But it turns out, all I will require are your imaginations.
it's monsoon season.